We come down there, there's the tablinum.
Non passare di là perché trava.
Sure. Now, if we look down across the garden, we should be able to spot the strangely placed columns, and on the opposite end there are the exedrae with the paintings, and over there is the dining room on that side. If we come to now, this room opposite was said to be where the possible cult statues of the ancestors were. Down here, we should be able to find some of the service rooms. Some of the remains down here. Of the bath. Come back down into the main house, and directly opposite us on the other side of the peristyle is the triclinium, and you can see how the columns have been completely spaced apart there so that they have a view out across the garden. Now, there are some more parts of the bath suite, I think, over here. And this is the exedra where the images of the ancestors might have been kept. It's not entirely clear what those are. A little shrine. And there you can see painting and stucco at the top. Now this is the exedra where most of the paintings are damaged. But there is the Menander, which is what the house is named after. And if we turn around at this point in this room and look out across the building, there is the main line of the axis. And come round to here. And round to here. And remains of some of the people who lived here in this room. And this is the dining room here with some underfloor areas. Again, you can see how very heavily the room has had to be restored. And if we look round from the dining room across the garden, there, nice wide space between the columns to give the complete impression. Now the hole in the wall you can see ahead may well have been made by salvagers trying to get into the house to recover stuff. Shows us to the entrance of the house again, and if I film the main axis, you can see the line through. There's the Lararium, the household gods, and then we can see through the house.